In this video, we're going to take a look at working with different trigger events and actions in Storyboard. Right now, I have an application with three different screens, and in the menu, I've set up some actions that perform some screen changes. But what I'd like to do is run an animation that moves the thermostat before we move to a new screen. And I've already actually gone ahead and I've made that animation. So here, if I preview it, you can see that I slide this thermostat to the left. First, the temperature controls kind of collapse behind the main part of the thermostat, then it slides to the left, and then we want to do that screen change. So let's take a look at how we're going to do that. If I take our weather button here and then go to the actions view, here I've got this press event that calls the screen fade. So I can either delete this action and put it in a new one, or if you double click on the action, you're able to change which action gets called. So here I'm going to select animation, and now all I need to do is say which animation that I'm going to run. And so for this, we're going to show that thermostat hide, and if I simulate the application, we'll be asked to save our changes. So now when I run this, when I hit this button, we'll move that thermostat over to the left. So at this point here, this is when I want to make that screen change. So we'll set that up now. At the application level, what I'm going to do is right click, add an action. And here, what I can do is in the event filter, if I start putting in animation, I'm given a list of all my different sort of animation trigger events. And if I select this here, you're given a description of your trigger event down below. And this trigger event is thermostat hide, which is the animation that we're running. And so we're saying thermostat hide, animation complete. So that can be a trigger event. When your animation's done, it's ready to perform an action. And so the action that we're going to use is a screen fade that takes us to that weather screen. So here, I'll select the weather screen. We'll set the duration to be 250 milliseconds. And now, when we simulate that, save our changes again, and here we go. So now we're back to the weather screen running that animation. And if I go back to the thermostat screen, here you can see the thermostat is back where we left it. So we also want to set up an animation that puts it back to where it was. And that is an animation that I already set up as well. I've got thermostat show and hide. So on the thermostat screen, what I can do is add an action here. If I right-click it, say add action, and for this, in my event triggers, if I put in screen, here I've got all these different screen trigger events, and I've got screen show post. So the event description here saying that this event gets triggered after the screen is shown. So when we see the screen, we're going to run the animation that puts the thermostat back, which is thermostat show. When I hit finish, now that action is in place. So when I hit simulate, save those changes, you can see there's a little wiggle on the plus and minus buttons. We'll take a look at that in a second. Here we go to the weather screen, and that works all right. And going back, screen show post, we put the thermostat back in place. Now, when we started up the app, you saw that the plus and minus buttons did kind of a little stretch out to the side and back in. And what they're doing is on the thermostat show animation, which we're going to run right now, you can see they kind of like overshoot and then come back in. But I don't really want that to happen when I start up the application like this. What I'd prefer is for them to come out from the center. So I'm going to set up one more action to get this going. So here, at the application level, I'll add an action. And for this, if I put in application, here I've got some trigger events for application start, application stop. So for starting the application, what I'm going to do is call an action of a data change. And here, where I set my parameters, I'll add arguments. So over here, I'm able to select different variables throughout my whole application. And what I want to do is when the application starts, I want to hide those plus and minus controls. So if I go to my thermostat screen, select the thermostat layer, and go down to the plus control, in the middle column here, this is a list of all the different variables that I can sort of grab here. And we're going to work with that GRDX variable. I'm going to select this, move it over to the right. So that's going to be added as part of the data change. And I also want to do the same thing with that minus control. Here, I'm going to grab that GRDX. This one's on the left, so it's at 26 pixels. And I'll move it over there. And I'll hit finish. And you can see these are those two values. Now, I can change those values here to be, you know, behind the center part in the middle of the screen. But if you don't and hit finish, you're still able to make those changes in the properties view here. This is that application action for GRE init, doing that data change. So I'll say we'll put these at 310 on the x-axis, which will be in the middle of the screen here. And if I simulate and save our changes, now you can see they come out from the center when we start the application. I'll do that again. So they pop out from the middle. Here we move the thermostat and transition, and when we come back, we can move the thermostat back into place. So that is getting started with different trigger events and types of actions in Storyboard Suite. Thanks for watching.